I'm Nicola Dixon, and I'm an artist and a designer. And I turn my creativity, my designs, into products. And also I get commissions to do artwork, public artwork, all sorts of logos and things as well. I didn't plan on being an artist. It's quite entertaining. But life had other plans for me. And I went from having a degree in geography and anthropology into going sailing on traditional sailing boats. Actually with post-viral fatigue and not being able to work. So I made jewellery to finance life. I then was very early on commissioned to make jewellery for Manx National Heritage. I made specific jewellery for different organisations on the island as well. So I did wildlife work for Wildlife Trust and Archibald Knox work. And I also worked with Tony Lewis and Celtic Gold and became familiar with Archibald Knox's work there. I was into knitting early on. My extended essay at school was all about knitting, and I started drawing knitting when I was 17, 18. And maybe I just kind of got that flow in the way. And then when I started doing this work, this jewellery work, I just started to learn their construction. Just really enjoyed drawing them, and I think actually I just lost time when I did them actually, and I just did loads of them. I lived in the hills, didn't have a driving license, wasn't very well, and I think I developed a mastery at that time in my 20s. And then when I revisited it, I also just lost time drawing knots, developing, making them more complex. And then as I studied them, I took them back to a simple form, and now there's a simple baseline, but there's a more complex form. It's interesting, but I think I've gained a flowing mastery and my brain can work with it. Well, I've had some really interesting commissions. I've had two, three CD covers, actually one for Greg, which has been great, and two for Matt Creer, which was very much into locking Celtic work. I did a logo for Young Cruniacht. And then there's a big chunk of metal down in the Peel Square, which is a flowing Celtic prayer in pierced stainless steel. And I've currently got a big commission on the go, which is top secret at the moment, for sort of modern Celtic design. That's going to be very exciting when it's revealed. You know, it's interesting, I was invited to speak at the International Day of Celtic Art and to present about my work and Archibald Knox, but unfortunately that was cancelled due to COVID, but hopefully that'll happen again, and that's people from Ireland, Scotland and America take part in that, so that was a very exciting invitation. And then there's Russians that share my work when I put it on Instagram, Russian and tattooists, because it's, you know, it's like just that lovely design. So yeah, there is interest in it, and I think I need to sort of separate it from my Manx work, because it is such it's a very strong design that I have, that people, you can almost spot my work because it's very much my line and my colouring. There's a lot of excitement in what can happen in the future with it. Well, it's interesting because we don't really know, but it's how you feel about your work. And I know that when I'm calm and still, the work has a different resonance to it. And when I designed a load of triskels initially, when I was doing a lot of meditation at the time, and I would look at them, they would almost hum. It was hilarious. It was just like, what's going on here? And I have had reflections from people that there's a lot of energy within them. So when I do work, I try to remain still so that that energy and that calmness is within it. I did another piece of work for the mental health unit, and I was very conscious that stillness and sort of peace should be in that. And so I kind of would often meditate before I would paint, because you wanted that within it. And maybe that's what people pick up, and often it's subconscious how you react to work. I know that people just like having my work in their houses, like living with it. So that's a happy outcome, and the spirituality thing is, it's all a mystery, but I like to think there's a bit of magic in my work.